guys, welcome to your weekly versus. My name is Midnight Strike, and today we're going to compare two bands, two metalcore bands, Shadows Fall and All That Remains. And these bands are compared often because at one point or another, Phil Labonte, the vocalist from All That Remains, was actually in Shadows Fall. They actually had one album with him, and it was their debut. So to get started, Shadows Fall formed in 95 and dropped Somber Eyes to the Sky in 1997. All That Remains was formed a year later, in 1998, while Phil was still in Shadows Fall. They didn't really do anything, though, until 2002, when right after Phil was kicked out of the band, a couple years, actually, in, believe it was 2000 or 1999. I know in 2000 they released Of One Blood, which was their first release, with which was Shadows Fall's first release with Brian Fair, new vocalist. They have him to this day. Amazing vocals, amazing screams. I love his style. It's very unique and it's very consistent throughout Shadows Fall's career. That's one thing that should be noted about Shadows Fall, is they've really stuck it consistent throughout their entire career. They've remained pretty much what they started. I mean, they've innovated throughout album to album. They have innovated and tweaked their sound just a little bit, but for the most part, they don't experiment around like All That Remains does. So, but then again, you know, I only have Fire from the Sky, Retribution, and The War Within. So, I mean, I've heard other songs. I've heard a few off Of One Blood, heard a few off, I've heard Redemption. A couple other ones off that album. I forget what it's called. But, I'll admit, I'm not the biggest Shadows Fall fan, but I do respect what they did for the genre. I do love his voice. I do love Fire from the Sky. That's probably my all-time favorite album by them. If not, you know, The War Within, because of course, The Light That Blinds. But, anyways, Brian Fair came in 2000. They've been working with him ever since. It's been about 13 years now. So, yeah. All That Remains, on the other hand, have played it differently. They released Behind Silence and Solitude in 2002, which was death metal and just growling, screaming. Me, personally, I don't really like Phil Labonte's early style. That's just me. I believe I said that in my All That Remains, A War You Cannot Win review, and I said I didn't really like Behind Silence and Solitude that much. I kind of think it's shit, but that's just me. They tweak their sound immensely. This is a band that likes to experiment. They tweak their sound immensely with This Darkened Heart, and polish it off even further with The Fall of Ideals, and this is actually what most fans, and myself, consider to be their best album, is The Fall of Ideals, which was released in 2006. This Darkened Heart came before it in 2004, and then 2008 comes along and we get Overcome. You know, I like Overcome. I love Overcome. I mean, I think it's a continuation of their Fall of Ideals sound, but with a lot more singing in it, and it's actually what really first got me into All That Remains. So, I knew about Shadows Fall from The Light That Blinds. I wasn't really into that vocal style that much, or just that style of music in general, because I was more into just traditional heavy metal, thrash metal. Wasn't really much of a screaming person until I got All That Remains, and then I heard 2 weeks, didn't really have any screaming in it. Loved that song. I listened to that song on repeat, so really it's what eased me into All That Remains in the first place. So I actually really like that album, you know, just Before the Damned, Sharyon, 2 weeks, Forever in Your Hands, all good, all great, phenomenal songs, and I just love the production value on it. I mean, it's got like really heavy bass, really heavy downtuned guitars. I don't know, it's just something about it is really good. And then For We Are Many drops in 2010, and production stale. They've kind of lost their musicianship. A couple good songs here and there, but it doesn't top The Fall of Ideals. It doesn't top Overcome. In my opinion, this is their second worst album. And then The War You Cannot Win. You guys already know what I think of it. Mixed bag. Got really good songs on it, but then again, it's got really bad ones. So it's kind of like, eh. But that is all that remains, and all that remains typically tend to experiment more with their music, whereas Shadows Fall kind of play it safe or keep a consistent path, and don't really experiment that much. But at the same time, you know, they produce good music. They both produce stellar music. So, but all that remains usually catches the flack for putting out, you know, the War You Cannot Win's albums, or For We Are Many, or, you know, even Overcome got some flack for not screaming in some songs. So, which one do you guys like better? I would have to say that, you know, I know more about Shadows Fall, or I know more about All That Remains, and, but I love Shadows Fall. I love the, Fire From the Sky album. That's probably my favorite album by them, as I said before, you know, and then The Light That Blinds Off the War Within. Love that song. What was the other one called? It was Enlightened by the Cold. I love that song, too. That song is just awesome. But, you know, I think that Brian Fair has a little bit more of like a crisp, consistent kind of vocal style when compared to Phil Labonte. Because Phil has been evolving his voice, and it's been changing pretty much from album to album, it seems. His voice is a lot more thin, a little bit more higher. It's not as whole as it was in The Fall of Ideals, or even Overcome. But it just seems like it's wearing a little thin. And that's just me. I love All That Remains. I love their new stuff. Love their old stuff. But yeah, it seems like it's wearing a little bit thin. He can still sing like a beast. But yeah, I mean, Brian Fair's voice, on the other hand, he has this amazing style where he's shouting and singing and screaming at the same time. It sounds great. So, I mean, I think I'm probably going to have to get more into Shadows Fall and get their back work a little bit. Of One Blood I still have to get, and I keep forgetting the one. See, okay, this is bothering me. Let's see. Threads of Life, that's what it is. The one with Redemption on it. Threads of Life. I'm gonna get that album. I'm just gonna listen to their back work, see what I think, because all I have are these three albums. So, really good band. Both of them are really good bands. But you know what? Hey, what do you guys think? Shadows Fall or All That Remains? I can't really decide, because I think that the better vocalist is probably Brian Fair, in my opinion. But, for metalcore, of course. But, I don't know. I know more about, All That Remains, so. And I don't know if they're going to be able to top The Fall of Ideals. Shadows Fall. I don't know if Shadows Fall can top that. So, but, like I said, what do you guys think? This was meant to generate a little bit of discussion. So, if you have something to say, comment. Don't forget to sub if you haven't already. So, I enjoy hearing from you guys. This is Midnight Strike 3625. Keep calm and rock on.